We know that corruption in urban development is one of the central challenges of our time, and that urban planners can play an important role in tackling it.
We also understand that research from a variety of perspectives has contributed to an evolution of anti-corruption strategies.
In short, a shift in focus from compliance to one of integrity.
So how do we activate the integrity of urban planners?
Here are three building blocks to consider.
First, we must debunk a common myth about corruption, that it's about a few bad apples that spoil the barrel.
In fact, evidence suggests that perfectly well-intentioned people can end up doing extremely bad things, if and when context allows. Corruption is not about a few bad apples. It's about the rotten barrels that can tarnish even the good ones. We all tend to overestimate our capacity for goodness and underestimate the slippery slope into corruption.
So the focus must be on designing good barrels, an institutional context that encourages integrity, all the while remaining humble and alert, because it's easy to become corrupted.
Second, let's focus on the integrity of urban planning as a profession. Currently, most efforts to promote integrity focus on individuals and their conduct, or on organizations and their culture. Yet, there's another potent but overlooked way to promote integrity, the professions.
Professional communities form strong shared identities, offer continuous training, and run their own ethical infrastructures, such as code of conducts and licensing systems.
This means professional bodies, like planning associations, can nurture norms of integrity, provide practical tools for realizing them, and prevent or call out corrupt conduct when it occurs.
Third, integrity is at the center of the social contract between the planning profession and society. Society trusts planners to use their skills and expertise in the best interest of their clients and the general public. Professional integrity and fiduciary duty, as well as a commitment to inclusive, fair, and participatory processes, are thus foundational principles for planners and their professional community.
Therefore, we need not start from scratch. Already there is a thriving set of values here, as well as ongoing debate about these values to build on.
So, to recap, activating the urban planning profession for building cities of integrity is as important as it is promising.
We must take into account the lived experiences of planners and work with planning bodies to provide support infrastructures and training that empowers planners to play their part in realizing urban development that is just, inclusive, and not derailed by corruption.